Holy cow. What a day. Yeah. Mark it down. March 5th, 2024.
I am stunned. Stunned.
The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints is now the stewards over some very incredible, precious, historical locations, buildings, and documents.
Which is,
Holy cow. This is humongous.
It's big.
It's not just the Kirtland Temple. That would be enough to be super excited about. But it's also... Casey, we have big news.
Big news.
This is
big
breaking news. It just happened like minutes ago.
We're freaking out over here. Wow.
Major announcement.
I'm still processing what we just found out. This is a special episode that we've recorded because, I mean, we're talking just a few minutes ago. I'm sitting there talking to you and you're talking to me and we're just shooting the breeze before we record our episode. And we just received, I saw it in a Facebook post from a friend of mine, news that that Community of Christ has sold the Kirtland Temple, along with a number of historical properties, to the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, which is,
holy cow. This is humongous.
It's big. We're recording this on behalf of Scripture Central. Just so you know who we are, I'm Casey Griffiths.
I'm Scott Woodward.
We do a podcast for Scripture Central called Church History Matters. We talk about all kinds of things linked to church history. We generally do series where we go through and do a deep 5 or 6 hour dive into topics like translation of the Book of Mormon, First Vision, plural marriage, race, and the priesthood. And we are nerds when it comes to church history. Today's a huge day. Just as we were getting ready to record our podcast, we got news. And so we're going to take a few minutes and walk you through this and what we know and what we don't know. And we're going to be very candid in saying this is very much developing right now. And so we might miss some details, but we're going to try and give you the major, major details of what's happening right now with Community of Christ and the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
It's not just the Kirtland Temple. That would be enough to be super excited about. But it's also properties in Nauvoo, right? We're talking the Joseph Smith Homestead, where he and Emma live for a few years. The mansion house, the red brick store, my word. And then a bunch of documents. What documents do you remember from the news release, Casey?
Yeah, there's actually a wonderful kind of Q&A that the church put out along with this about what it involves. Question one, what was included in the transaction? It says the transaction involves land, buildings, artifacts, and documents. The real estate, along with some artifacts, are in Kirtland, Ohio, and in Nauvoo, Illinois, while artifacts and documents also come from Community of Christ Library and Archives in Independence, Missouri. The second question is, what are the most significant items? The answer, the most significant properties are the Kirtland Temple, the Smith Family Homestead, the Mansion House, the Nauvoo House, and the Red Brick Store. Significant documents and artifacts include manuscripts and the Bible used in the Joseph Smith translation of the Bible.
The Joseph Smith translation manuscripts.
Seven letters from Joseph Smith to his wife, Emma, John Whitmer's History of the Church, original portraits of Joseph and Emma Smith, the cornerstone of the Nauvoo House, the original door of Liberty Jail, and a document with the title of Characters, which may contain a sample of inscriptions from the gold plates. And then there's an appendix that has more details, but that starts us off rolling. So
this is an historic day.
This is, wow. Just to let our listeners kind of in on the significance of what this means, the Kirtland Temple is the center piece of the entire church community in Kirtland. It's the first house of the Lord built and dedicated by the church in this dispensation. It's where Jesus Christ appeared. This is noted in section 110 of the Doctrine and Covenants. Moses, Elias, and Elijah all appear within this sacred structure. The structure is the original building. It has been kept up and maintained by Community of Christ over the years. They've done a wonderful job preserving it, but for members of both churches, it is a highly significant building that holds a ton of meaning for us.
The very first temple built in this dispensation.
Yeah.
and the place, as you mentioned, where keys were restored, which the significance of those keys would take an hour to discuss, right? In fact, we've done so. The keys that are restored there are the keys that are eventually going to be used later on in future temples to help seal families together.
Yeah. And because the Kirtland Temple is so significant, I mean, we're talking about just about the only place on earth that you can point to and within a couple of feet say, this is a place where Jesus appeared. We should note that one of the Q&As was, will the Kirtland Temple be converted into a functioning Latter-day Saint temple? The answer was no. The Kirtland Temple will be maintained and presented as a historic building that's open to the public. The Kirtland Temple, under ownership of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, is going to continue to do what it did under ownership of Community of Christ. And I want to mention that everybody will be welcome. Like, anybody will be able to visit the Kirtland Temple and go into the Kirtland Temple just like they have been before ownership was transferred. So that's
come
the
learn
Kirtland
the history,
Temple.
Come learn the significance. Come sup on church history.
That is the beginning of this. The announcement also mentions the historic properties in Nauvoo, which includes...
Tell us.
Yeah. So they mentioned the Joseph Smith Homestead. This is the house that Joseph Smith's family lives in most of the time they're in Nauvoo. A little cabin on the banks of the Mississippi River. The Mansion House, which is the home Joseph Smith lives in for the last 8 months of his life. It's also used as kind of a hotel. The Nauvoo House, which is mentioned in Section 124 of the Doctrine and Covenants, kind of a house for strangers. And the Red Brick Store. The Red Brick Store, which is a recreation
the Red Brick Store.
Of the original Red Brick Store, is where the Relief Society was organized. It's also where the first endowments were given. It functions as sort of church headquarters.
Community center.
Yeah, yeah. So that's a huge deal too. And that I did not expect. I had been hearing rumors for a couple months that the Kirtland Temple was going to be sold, but I didn't expect the Nauvoo properties to be sold also during this time. So this is pretty stunning.
The Red Brick Store is almost the proto temple, right? It's before the Nauvoo Temple was completed. They're doing temple ordinances in the Red Brick Store. So
yeah. Joseph Smith says if the temple's not completed, then we can do it another place. The place that happens is the Red Brick Store. Now, alongside that, the historic artifacts.
I mean, these have some of the most incredible history of our church embedded in them. And so we're excited to see what the church does. But tell us about why those are significant.
Okay, so a ton of things that were kept by Emma Smith when the church moved west were eventually transferred into custody of Community of Christ. And that includes the Bible and the original manuscripts for the Joseph Smith translation, which is hugely significant to us. They mention the door from Liberty Jail, the cornerstone of the Nauvoo House. The cornerstone of the Nauvoo House is where Joseph Smith places the original manuscript of the Book of Mormon. To try and preserve it, water seeps in and most of the manuscript is destroyed. But that's been on display in the Nauvoo Temple Visitor Center. And the entire list of items actually lists several sunstones, moonstones, star stones from the Nauvoo Temple as well. And the homes in Nauvoo also include the Sidney Rigdon home. A stable built by Lewis Bitterman, a bunch of stuff that's currently owned by Community of Christ. Basically, everything that they had stewardship over in Nauvoo and Kirtland is listed as part of this. And so,
sounds like pretty much everything related to the Joseph Smith era.
Yeah, this is pretty much everything.
Wow.
And I am stunned. Q&A says, the church paid $192.5 million without assigning specific values to the properties and items. So this is kind of everything transferred into church control. And like I said, this isn't a huge shock.
Is this not a huge shock?
Okay. So back in 2017, Steve Veazey, who is the president of the church right now and was back then, they've named a successor, but she hasn't been put in place yet. In 2017, Steve Veazey sent out a letter saying that the church had, I think it was $115 million budget shortfall, that they needed to take care of the pensions for their employees. They needed to do this to provide retirement for them. And in the letter, I think his wording was, the church will consider to selling historic properties in order to meet its obligations. And it was only a couple of days after that that the printer's manuscript of the Book of Mormon sold for $35 million. And so this could be looked at as kind of the logical conclusion of that sequence of events, where Community of Christ has this, they need to take care of their employees. They need resources to operate their church. And so this is probably the end result of that process that started several years ago, too. So huge stuff. And let me pause for a moment and say, I work with Community of Christ quite a bit. Part of my work is I work with an interfaith team that meets with leaders from Community of Christ about every 6 months. I know that this is tough for them. And so I would plead with the members of our church to be gracious during this time. No triumphalism, you know, no spiking the football, because this is no gloating. Please be gracious, because this could be very difficult for some of our friends in Community of Christ, who we love and respect and who have done a wonderful job. Like, it's a real labor of love to care for these historic properties. And I would hope that we'd emphasize to them that this is something that honestly will stay a shared space, that members of Community of Christ are going to be welcome at all these sites. This is still going to be intermittent. I mean, one of our interfaith dialogues was held in the Kirtland Temple, in the top floor. We've also had interfaith dialogues at the Nauvoo historic sites that they're talking about here. We've done it in the Independence Temple, where some of these artifacts are stored. I want to emphasize to them that I'm grateful to know that these buildings and artifacts will be cared for by people that care about them, but I also recognize how this could be a hard day for a lot of people in Community of Christ, and my heart goes out to them. Like, they're my friends, and I love them, and I hope they're okay. This is tough stuff.
And we can only hope to be as gracious to them and anyone else who'd like to come and visit these sites as they were to us, as the stewards of these sites when they were under their ownership. And I've only had positive experiences visiting them under the care of the Community of Christ. And so we thank you, our brothers and sisters in the Community of Christ. That care, that love, that openness will be reciprocated. Let brotherly love continue. We plan on that. McCasey, for those who are lovers of our church history, whatever branch of the restoration movement you're from, like, this is a big day. This is a huge day. What an important moment in the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. You and I are church history nerds. We have a podcast called Church History Matters, where we nerd out about stuff like this, where we nerd out about all kinds of things, church history. We think it's really important and significant. If you're not aware of what we do on that, please come over and join us on Church History Matters. It's a podcast we have on Scripture Central. We're actually even recording a series right now about the significance of temples. We've even talked about the Kirtland Temple recently.
The last episode we just recorded was on the Kirtland Temple. And I was sitting there wondering, do we need to talk about ownership of the Kirtland Temple? And I'm glad we put it off, because it would have been outdated before it was published. Like, things are moving really, really quickly here. And so, wow. I mean, we hope... We're learning just as quickly as you are out there, and I'm going to need a little while to process this, Scott, to be honest with you. This is just something that I thought maybe I'd see happen, but now that it's happened, it's kind of a "where were you when you found out" sort of moment for me.
Holy cow, what a day. Yeah. Mark it down, March 5th, 2024. The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints is now the stewards over some very incredible, precious, historical locations, buildings, and documents.
stunning, stunning stuff. I'm really
come on over to Church History Matters. Come join us. We'd love to have you if you want to go do a deep dive with us about temple worship.
Yeah. Wow. Okay.
Thanks, Casey.
Well, exciting times, Scott.